everybody. This is Chef Priya, and yeah, I'm here once again to give you a very wonderful dish from potatoes. Potatoes are very versatile ingredient, something that can be whipped up into many other dishes. Today I'll show you how to make a very simple and easy to make batata bhaji. The ingredients, as usual, the most important ingredient is potatoes. What we need is some boiled potatoes, and they are cut into small cubes, as I've done this for you. We need a little of cumin seeds, jeera, that is commonly called, and we have some green chutney that is prepared. Now, green chutney you can whip up in very different ways. What I've done is I've taken coriander leaves, green chilies, and ginger, and I've grinded together and made into a nice fine paste. That is green chili paste or coriander leaves paste for you. You can even add a little of tinge of garlic if you would like to, just to have a very nice chutney flavor. Now I've got roasted peanuts, which are roasted and crushed. As usual, they're crushed very coarsely. We have got salt to taste, salt, and some grated or fresh coconut. Now this fresh coconut is a very optional one which you can add. Either you can add it as a garnish, or you can mix it up with your dish to give an extra coconut flavor to your batata bhaji. So now let's start with making our batata bhaji. First we need to light our pan and have a little oil in it. We don't require much of oil, very minimum oil for this bhaji. That's why it makes a very good vegetable preparation. Less of oil, and you don't have to fry or roast any of the potatoes over here. It's just a very simple bhaji preparation. Once your oil is hot, you need to add little of cumin seeds just to give a tempering or tadka. Once your cumin seeds start to splutter or they start making noise, you can add your boiled potatoes. I'm adding boiled potatoes to this mixture. Mix the potatoes very nicely so that the cumin seeds are coated. Now here you have to make sure you have boiled the potatoes very nicely. They are not half boiled or roughly boiled, because this bhaji, we don't cook it for a very long time. We just have to mix our ingredients together. Just we are heating up the gas, or we are using a little of heat to brighten up the flavor, so to give an extra flavor to our bhaji. After our potatoes are added to our kadai or to our tempering, we add little of a chutney. Now if you want to have a very spicy preparation, then you can have a little one extra green chili added to your chutney and make a very spicy preparation. But otherwise I prefer to have a little mild, so you can add a little of green chutney to your mixture. Now make sure your chutney is nicely coated and mixed well with the potatoes. Now one thing that you keep in mind while boiling potatoes is you need to add salt while boiling potatoes. Now potatoes absorb lots and lots of salt. So it's always better when you're boiling potatoes, you add salt to the water that you're boiling. So the potatoes also tend to take up the salt. And even in further dishes, when as you start making your dishes, you can lessen the quantity of salt to be added. Now we add a little quantity of salt, and we mix our dish very nicely, that is along with your chutney and potatoes. Now once your mixture is nicely done and nicely mixed with the salt and your green chutney, we are going to add our crushed peanuts. Now this crushed peanuts have to be added. It just gives a very crunchy and nutty flavor to our potato bhaji. That's the reason why we add our peanuts. Now the peanuts can be added roughly crushed, or we can just add whole peanuts as well. But then if the kids, they prefer to have some very small pieces of peanuts rather than huge pieces of peanuts. So I would prefer to have roughly coated, roughly crushed or coarsely crushed peanuts. And it also gives a very nice color to our batata bhaji with this peanuts. Our bhaji is almost done and we are ready for service. Sure you all are going to try this dish at home, and please do not forget to comment and subscribe. Thank you.